This is Coop and Cassis for IFL TV in association with MTK Global. It's Gibraltar, it's press conference day. I'm joined by the man himself, Mr. Chris Congo. Yes. How are you, mate? Looking very summery out here.
Yeah, of course. I'm good, man. You right?
All good, all good. How have you found the last sort of 24 hours? A bit weird. Had to bubble in Wembley, then we all got on the same flight here. And yeah, it's been a little bit of a whirlwind 24 hours.
I mean, I'm just taking everything in, man. It's all an experience for me, you know. This is my first time as a professional fighting abroad. So I'm just taking everything in.
So obviously, we caught up, I don't know, maybe 2 or 3 months ago when all this stuff was going on with Florian Marku, and everyone's kind of calling each other out. They all want these kind of fights. But I mean, fair play to your opponent, Michael McKinson, because he was kind of on the scene, but wasn't really on the scene in terms of everyone knowing who he is. He kind of had to be vocal, put himself out there, and he's got the fight view on a stage like this.
Yeah, well, to be honest, me personally, from the outside looking in, he was always on the scene. He was getting the fights. He was actively fighting. Whereas for me, I wasn't. So it was hard. It was hard for me looking from the outside, looking in, seeing all these guys fighting. I wasn't getting no fights. People didn't want to fight me. So I wanted to fight him, but he said he didn't want to fight me at the time. So now I'm at a bigger position and I'm at a better stage and a better platform. Now he wants to fight me. He's talking about he's been underrated and all of that stuff for so long. He hasn't been given the opportunity, which I understand. But he's been on the MTK shows, he's been headlining them shows. If I was headlining them shows, trust me, I'll be selling them out. And people will hear about it. So I'm just here trying to do my thing. And yeah, man, just working hard, bro.
So you come into this fight obviously off the back of a fantastic win last year against Lufa Clay, and that kind of set yourself up now for the fights to get bigger and better and really kind of test and see how good you really are.
Of course, and this is what I want. I didn't come into this game to be fighting any journeyman or anyone that people know I'm going to beat. I want the 50-50 fights, man, and it's only better for me, you know. When I fight better opponents, I perform much better. I'm always switched on. And you just see the best of Chris Congo, man. So this is the reason why I picked him as an opponent, you know.
What kind of fight can we expect to see on Saturday night here in Gibraltar? What type of fighter do you think McKinson is?
McKinson, he's a back foot fighter. He's not really got power like that, but he looks very strong on the inside and stuff. So I think he's either going to try and box how he usually does and how he does in his last fight, or he's going to try and bring it. But whichever one he brings, I'll always be able to adapt and always be ready for anything. Like, I don't know. I'll just always be ready, man. It's just as simple as that, you know.
There's so many good matchups in your division. I know we've spoken about many of these opponents in the past, but is it a case of one by one, you know, slowly but surely everyone will get their turn?
Of course, of course. Obviously, Lufa Clay, he got it at the worst time. Probably my last fight was the time where I could have been beaten because I'd been out for so long, ring rust, all of that. But somehow I still managed to perform well. So now I'm active, it's bigger problems. And I keep saying this. And Saturday, I'm going to show everyone, show the world what I'm about. So I'm looking forward to it. But in terms of everyone else, it's I'm just taking one fight at a time, man. So Michael McKinson first this coming Saturday.
I get that. And it's awkward, especially during a fight week, because you have got a big fight in McKinson this week. But there's idiots like me that do want to ask you about other opponents as well, and you've got to kind of keep yourself focused, which I know you do, but there is like these guys out there, Conor Benn, Marku, all these guys, but you want these guys, surely?
I wanted them guys from a long time. I showed you that I wanted Marku on 4 days' notice. He was talking about championship weight. I didn't care about that. Well, you know what? I don't even care about him. I don't care about any of these guys in the welterweight division. Only got one person on my mind, and that's McKinson.
We know, even though Dillian White is in the fight of his life this week, I know he would have been talking to you during the build-up to this and kind of giving you his advice, etc.? What has he really kind of said to you ahead of this fight with McKinson?
He just said, take the opportunity as he comes. He knows I can beat McKinson. That's why when we sat down and had the meeting about this, he's like, yeah, we're going to get McKinson. I said, let's go. He said, I know you can beat this guy. You got all the skills. You got all the tools to do it. And you're going to do it regardless. So, yeah, that's what he said.
Have you managed to get out one of these £2 coins yet with Dillian's face on it?
No, I need one. You got one, bro?
Nah. I think they're going for like 40 quid, you know.
40 quid? You know what? I'll pay that, you know. I don't even mind.
I probably would. Just to have one of them coins, yeah, I probably would.
Yeah, I'll pay for a few of them, to be honest. Just save them.
I don't know what they've done with his face, though, Chris. They've like... I don't know. It was a bit questionable, wasn't it?
Well, he's ugly anyway, so it don't matter. So he's all right, you know what I mean? So either way, you don't care. But I want to get one hold of them £2 coins.
Well, talk of the man there, look. He's
Look at this guy. Look. He's always... Look at... You know? He's cut his hair now. He's gone back to the bold look. But that's good. I think this time round you'll see more of a savage Dillian White. And because there's crowds are back, which is good. I'm happy crowds are back. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to it, man.
You confident he can kind of right the wrong that happened in fight camp last August?
Very confident. Dillian is strong in the mind. And, you know, in this sport, it's 90% mental in boxing. And I know he can do it.
Chris, thank you very much for your time. I'll let you get on with the rest of your morning. It is actually brightening up here. It's a lovely day here in Gibraltar. I can see. Are they Uggs?
Yeah, bro.
Oh, sorry.
I got the Uggs out, of course. Shorts.
Ugg slippers, by the way. You can't see them there.
But you know the swag, bro.
Chris Congo, thank you very much. Wish you the best of luck on Saturday night.
Nice one. Thank you, bro.